Hi, in this video we are going to see GATE previous year questions with answers for electrical engineering. Power system, set number 9. In this set we are going to see 10 different questions. Okay. First question. A single phase induction motor draws 12 megawatt power at 0.6 lagging power factor. Okay. A capacitor is connected in parallel to motor to improve the power factor of the combination of motor and capacitor to 0.8 lagging. Assuming that the real and reactive power drawn by the motor remains same as before, the reactive power delivered by the capacitor is in megawatt is. Okay, so they have given this is a 12 megawatt system. Okay, so power factor has been improved from 0.6 to 0.8 by connecting the capacitor bank. Okay, so you connected a capacitor bank, the power factor is improved. So they are asking you what is the reactive power. Okay, it is delivered by the capacitor. Okay, so reactive power delivered by the capacitance, we can calculate power into tan phi old minus tan phi new. Okay, tan phi old means old power factor, that is a 0.6 lagging. Okay, tan phi new means new power factor 0.8, it's the improved power factor 0.8 lagging. So we can substitute, calculate like 12 into tan cos inverse of 0.6 minus tan cos inverse of 0.8. okay, 7 megawatt. So answer is 7 megawatt. So in this question they are given the power, they are given the power factor after installation of capacitor bank, they have given the power factor. Okay, they have asked you to find out the reactive power transfer. So reactive power transfer is 7 megawatt. A 110 kV single core coaxial XLPE insulated power cable delivering a power at 50 Hz has a capacitance of 125 nanofarad per kilometer if the dielectric loss tangent of XLPE is 2 × 10⁻⁴. The dielectric power loss in the cable in watt per kilometer is, so they have told the it's a 110 kV voltage system. XLPE means cross linked polyethylene cable. It's a type of cable, it is advancement of PLC cable, sorry, PVC cable, polyvinyl chloride. Okay, when comparing with polyvinyl chloride, glass linked polyethylene cable will be having high insulation strength for the lesser thickness. Okay, so dielectric loss equal to V square omega C tan delta. So the voltage given is 110 kV, so we have to substitute 110 into 1000 whole square. So 110 kV, omega is 2 pi f, 2 × 1.414 × 50. C is a capacitance value. Okay, capacitance is 125 nanofarad per kilometer. So 125 × 10⁻⁹. So nano, so we have substituted minus 9. Then tan delta. Tan delta is a loss tangent. So they have given 2 × 10⁻⁴. So 2 × 10⁻⁴. If we calculate, it will be coming around 95 watts per kilometer. So they have asked you to find out the dielectric loss in the cable watt per kilometer. Okay, so you have to for each core will be 95/3, so 31.7 watts per kilometer. In this question they have given the voltage of the system, it's a cross linked polyethylene cable, and they have given the capacitance of the system, and dielectric loss of the system has been already given. So the dielectric loss tangent has been already given. So dielectric loss equal to V square omega C tan delta. So V is 110 kV, 2 pi f we have to substitute in for omega, and tan delta we have to substitute, then we get the answer. Okay, and we have to calculate for each core, dividing the answer by 3. So 31.7 watt per kilometer. For enhancing the power transmission in along EHV transmission line, the most preferred method is to connect a series capacitor to compensate the line. Okay, so normally the reactive power transferred or power transfer equal to V square by X. Okay, if you increase the value of power, if in order to increase the value of power for the same voltage, the reactance has to be reduced. Okay, if you connect series capacitance, the reactance will be reduced. For the same voltage, you will transfer more power. Again, I'm repeating, for transferring more power at the same voltage, the denominator X has to be reduced. Okay, if you reduce the reactance by connecting the capacitance, okay, so the increase in reactance value will allow the more power to transfer for the same voltage level. A single phase load is supplied by a single phase voltage source. If the current flowing from the load is load to the source is 10 angle minus 150, if the voltage at the load terminals is, okay, so they have asked you whether the load is observes the real power or reactive power, whether it is delivers, like that they are asked. Okay, here the voltage, here thing to be observed is the current is flowing from the load to the source. So I have shown the arrow mark in the reverse direction, 100 angle minus 150. So I have shown in the reverse direction, and the voltage at the terminal is 100 angle 60. Okay, so impedance equal to Z equal to minus V by Z. So it is current is flowing in the reverse direction. So we have to substitute minus 10, minus 10 angle minus 150. Okay, since the direction of current is reversed, so minus and minus it will get nullified. So answer will be plus. Okay, so by substituting the value, we will get 8.66 plus J 5 ohms. So the load is RL. So therefore, load observes real and reactive power. So answer B is right. So here the main thing to be observed is this power flow is from load to source. Okay, so minus I have put it. A lightning stroke discharges impulse current of 10 kiloamps peak and on 400 kV transmission line having a surge impedance of 250 ohms. The magnitude of transient over voltage traveling waves in either direction, assuming equal distribution from the point of lightning stroke. So they have told it, they have asked you to find out the traveling waves in either direction. Okay, as the current is equally distributed, current on each side will be, so they have given 10 kA, so you have to divide by 2, so 5 kA will be one side. Okay, surge impedance value is 250 ohms, they have already given. So the magnitude of transmission voltage is 250 into 5 kV, so 1250 kV. Here the important thing to be observed is the magnitude of the transient over voltage traveling the wave in either direction, assuming equal distribution. So since it is in equal distribution, we are dividing by 2, equal distribution form. A load center of 120 megawatt derives the power from two power stations connected by 220 kV transmission lines of 25 km and 75 km as shown in the figure. The three generators G1, G2 and G3 are 100 megawatt capacity each, having identical fuel cost characteristics. The minimum loss generation schedule for supplying. So they have told three generators, okay, G1, G2, G3, all the three are equal capacity, 100 megawatt each. Okay, one generator is 25 km from away and another two generators are away from 75 km. So they have asked you to find out the economic load dispatch value. Okay, the economic load dispatch value we can calculate. The nearest generator has to deliver more power. In this particular case, the nearest generator is G1. So G1 has to deliver more power and G1 has to cater all the losses, because if it delivers more power, you will be more efficient. So you are loading the G2 and G3 at the lesser possible way. Okay, and the total load to be delivered is 120 megawatt. So we can see the case C. So P1, P2, P3, all the three are equal megawatt. So case C is wrong, because P1 has to deliver more power than P2 and P3, other two generators. So case C is wrong. Then case D also wrong, because P1 is delivering only 30 megawatt and P2, P3 are higher. Okay, so case C and D are wrong. So either A or B will be the answer. And the losses has to be delivered by P1, the generator, highest capacity, like nearest generator. So okay, P1 equal to 80 megawatt plus losses. So in this particular case, P1 is 80 megawatt plus losses is the right answer. And the other two generators has to share the load equally. So the choice A is the right answer. So P1 equal to 80 megawatt, 20-20. Again, I'm repeating here, the thing to be observed is we know all the three generators are equal capacity. Okay, the nearest generator has to deliver the maximum possible load, other two generators has to deliver equal load. Okay, all the generators are equal capacity, so choice A is the right answer. In a biased differential relay, the bias is defined as the ratio of. In a biased differential relay, the normally the bias is the ratio of operating coil current by restraining coil current. Choice B is the right answer. In a biased differential relay, the bias is defined as the ratio of operating coil current and restraining coil current. A shunt reactor of 100 megawatt is operated at 98% of rated voltage and at 96% of rated frequency. The reactive power absorbed by the reactor is, okay, the capacity of reactor is 100 megawatt, okay, they are operating at 98% of rated voltage and 96% of rated frequency. So reactive power absorbed is, so reactive power is V square by XL, okay, V square by 2 pi FL. So instead of V, we are going to substitute 0.98 V. Instead of F, we are going to substitute 0.96 F. Okay, if we substitute, the value will be 1.000416 into 100 megawatt. So 100.0416 megawatt. Okay. Again, I'm repeating. They are given the shunt reactor of 100 megawatt. It will be operated at 98% of rated voltage and 96% of rated frequency. So they are asking you to find out the reactive power absorbed by the reactor. Reactive power absorbed by the reactor is V square by XL. So V square by 2 into pi into FL. Okay. Instead of V, we have to substitute 0.98 V. Instead of F, we have to substitute 0.96 F. Okay. By substituting, we will get 100.04 megawatt. Choice D is the right answer. This particular question is asked in the year 1998. In a power system, the fuel input per hour for the plants 1 and 2 is given. So they are given the fuel input F1 and F2, 0.2 P1 square. Actually, it is written P12. Okay, it's P1 square plus 30 P1 plus 100. F2 equal to 0.25 P2 square plus 40 P2 plus 150. Okay, they are, the limits of generators are 20 less than or equal to P1 less than or equal to 80. So 40 less than or equal to P2 less than or equal to 200 megawatt. Find the economic operating schedule of the generation if the load demand is 130 megawatt, neglecting the transmission line. Okay, they are given the fuel cost. So for economic operation, we have to find out the incremental fuel cost DF by DP. Okay, and DF2 by DP2. For economic operation, DF1 by DP1 equal to DF2 by DP2. So fuel cost 1 equal to 0.2 P1 square plus 30 P1 plus 100. So DF1 by DP1 equal to 0.2 P1 into 2. So 0.4 P1 plus 30. Fuel cost 2 is 0.25 P2 square plus 40 P2 plus 150. So DF2 by DP2 equal to, so it is DP2. 0.5 P2 plus 40. For economic operation, 0.4 P1 plus 30 equal to 0.5 P2 plus 40. So P2 equal to 0.8 P1 minus 20. So this is the first equation. The total load to be delivered is 130 megawatt. So P1 plus P2 equal to 130 megawatt. It's the second equation. So by solving this, we can get the answer P1 equal to 83.33, P2 equal to 46.67. Okay. So P1 value is coming higher than the maximum limit. So they have drawn the limit as 80 megawatt. So we can take P1 as 80 megawatt. So if you take P1 as 80 megawatt, the remaining is will be taken care by the second one. So 130 minus 80, so 30. So incremental cost of P1, incremental cost one is 0.4 into P1 is 80 plus 30. So 62 rupees per megawatt hour. Incremental cost of second is 0.5 into 50. Plus 40 equals 65 rupees per megawatt hour. Okay, so this is the answer. This is a 5 mark question in 1998. Okay, and again repeating, in the power system they have given the fuel cost. So F1 is one value they have given, F2 is another value given, and they have given the limits of the generators. So P1 will be 20 to 80, P2 will be 40 to 200. So they have asked you to find out the economic operating schedule. And they have given the load demand as 130. So in this type of question, we have to see incremental fuel cost. We have to see DF1 by DP1. We have to see DF2 by DP2. We have to see, and we have to equate the df1 by dp1 equal to df2 by dp2, and we can take this as a first equation, and we know that p1 plus p2 is the demand, so p1 plus p2 is 130 megawatt in this case. So we, by solving this equation 1 and 2, we will get the answer. The angle, okay, angle in the swing equation of the synchronous generators, okay, this is an angular displacement of the axis fixed to the rotor with respect to the synchronously rotating axis, okay. This is normally called the power angle. So power angle in the swing equation, okay, angular displacement of axis fixed to the rotor with respect to the synchronously rotating axis. This particular question is asked in the year 2015, okay. You please try this question, give the answer in the comment box, okay. And this question I will be answering in the next set, set number 10. In this question I will just explain. Consider the economic dispatch problem for the power plant having two generating units. The fuel cost is in rupees per megawatt hour they are given, along with the generation limit they are given. So the incremental cost of the plant when it supplies 200 megawatt, it is similar to the case what we have seen earlier. Okay, please try this question. So just I have given the hint, whatever given already. Reactive power injected by the sunt capacitance P into P equal to P into tan phi volt minus tan phi nu. So we have used in the first question. And dielectric loss is V square omega C tan delta, and power is V square by X. Okay. By connecting the series capacitance, we can increase the power transfer for the same voltage. And reactive power is V square by XL, V square by 2 into 4.414 FL. Thanks for listening. In case if you have any clarification, please contact. Thank you.